And there he is, Kenny Hope, who first refereed a game here back in 1981. Is doing a bit of mending, bit of groundwork there. Handyman. I'm sure he'll hope it's the hardest work he has to do tonight. And I suppose he stands an outside chance of refereeing the final itself. Off goes Celtic. Clear favourites to get to the final. But we've had that in semi-finals before. Almost. Ryan McClure is very sharp. Almost picking it up. Ideal area of the park for McClure that, by the way. Derek Murray. Deep, and there's John Riley. Danny McGrain at fullback with Young White going into the middle beside Aiken, and there was Danny McGrain, and that was a little suspicion of a nudge. Kenny Hope was very close beside him. There's a run by McClure, and he almost gets a touch. Oh dear, oh dear. Surely Tommy McClure can't allow his defence to play like that. Absolute huge tunnel appearing in that defense. Look, McClure right down it and very intelligently opting for that touch for goal, which was just out, and that is a very fragile looking Motherwell defense. Oh, just a bit too much there by Steve Kirk. Kirk, one of the players that Tommy McClure had some doubts about before the start of this evening, but he's recovered, had a late fitness test. This is a man who makes fitnesses byword. Danny McGrain slightly off with that pass. That should be covered by White. Now White is a fullback. He was telling me that he'll long remember that experience he had against Ted McMahon at Ibrox, but I think he's learned from it, and a young player like that should benefit by that kind of experience. That was Willie McStay, Danny McGrain, Owen Archdeacon. Motherwell have got everybody back by the two front men, John Riley, and just beside him Steve Kirk, and there is Burns. Modern McLeod. We did get it through. Mo Johnson. McClure's going in. Nice switch there by Mo Johnson, and he certainly knew where the support was coming. Ryan McClure going right through the middle of the penalty area. Easily mopped up there by White, who's having a very good game. As I said, White is a fullback, but because of circumstances, Celtic might be producing for themselves a very good centre-back, and at a tender age. Oh, Farningham. Good tackle by McGrain, though. That's what I mean by never letting Celtic down at crucial moments like that. He does make his mistakes, perhaps more than he would in his younger days, but when it matters, watch it. Look, listen, crunch. McGrain. Archdeacon. There is White. Rain wants to go on one of his runs, just a bit too much. Well, Jock Steen used to say about Danny McGrain, if only he could have finished, he would have been one of the greatest ever at fullback position. Well, he was almost that, but Danny's finishing was never one of the brightest aspects of his game. Oh, nicely touched down Farningham. John Riley in the middle, There's Willie McStay. Oh, blunder by McStay. He had to whip that away, you know, right out the park sort of stuff. He hesitated, and he who does that is almost lost, not quite. Tempting ball, used ball, and look at that, almost at a fankle. Motherwell's first corner. That rather dingy area of Hampden Park, and an easy one for Bonner. Tries to find Mo Johnston. Riley, very good ball down. Oh, brushed away by Aiken, Paul Smith. Yeah, a bit of a push in that. Free kick. That's the Smith. Well, that was a very useful save, you know. There might have been a bit of skid on that. Corner kick. The last 5 minutes of this match have belonged to Motherwell, very clearly. As Bonner tries to go in, he still hasn't got it. And it's off the line. Paul McStay coming to the rescue. And any of three Motherwell players might have had an opportunity there. And that's offside. And I did not think I would use tonight in commentary the pressure being relieved on the Celtic defence, but that's exactly what I'm doing now. After that real scramble, the goalkeeper simply did not know where he was. Two players didn't know where the ball was. And eventually that flick there by Smith on the outside of the foot was swept away. Tommy Burns. On there by Owen Archdeacon, and once or twice the Motherwell fullback Fraser Wishart has been caught out of position for that longish ball. I think he should be tucking himself further back off Archdeacon if he's going to be caught like that. Out of a cloud. Stay Kennedy, and there's a beautiful goal by McClare. So typical, breaking the deadlock and out of virtually nothing. I mean, how many balls have we seen already tonight like this? And it quickly coped good by the Motherwell defence, except on that one occasion, and that is all that that man needs. A man, in my estimation, who should certainly be included in Scotland's international squad for the next game in Ireland. Well, the Motherwell goalkeeper may just have injured himself in landing. Most of us, I think, were watching the flight of the ball into the net, and we forgot the poor soul who fell on his shoulder. However, let's have a look at this time at the goalkeeper. For humanitarian reasons, down he goes. And, oh yes. Tommy McLean must be annoyed about that, I suppose, even on reflection. Kennedy committing himself when he did, totally misjudged that cross, allowing McLaren for that quite lethal header. Archdeacon, 4 minutes to half time. Morris Johnston. Not too obvious a ball by Tommy Burns. That's McStay. Well, Johnston all on his own. No cover. And the goalkeeper is distinctly at a disadvantage now. And I think he'll want to hold on, if possible, to half time. They're only, as I said, just under 4 minutes away from that, and he is suffering. I feel for him. Stay to Danny McGray. Burns. Johnston. Wishart. On the line to Riley. Over. Archdeacon. That's a useful ball again. McClure was up for it. Now watch how tentatively John Gardner is treating that ball, and it will be very interesting indeed to see if John comes back on to take any further part in the proceedings as the halftime whistle goes, and off comes Celtic in that, I now think, dominant and commanding position as a result of that one incisive touch which beat John Gardner, coming from Brian McClure, the 38th minute. And pleasant to report that John Gardner has come on to restart the second half of the game. Delighted to. I don't think he's going to be fully mobile, but I'm sure he's trying his best for his club. And there he is, the big broad shoulders of the Celtic substitute, Alan McInally. That's the only change in the format so far, with Owen Archdeacon having gone off. Well, full credit to Motherwell, they played extremely well in defence. I'll say about two-thirds of that first half. You couldn't fault them for that, and then came that sudden goal. And that's what Celtic do have, the ability to turn a game like that. Two excellent players up front, and even though they're having a mediocre spell, as if, unfortunately for themselves, had tonight. Wishart. Oh, nice dunning by Wishart. There's a shot. Well, 10 out of 10 for effort in that. Deciding to have a go. And if McLean has told his side, come out and attack, then the message has got through to Wishart with a shot like that. Although Border, in all honesty, had his eyes glued in that ball all the way. Johnson brilliantly to this side, that must be the shot! Great play by Johnson and McInally. Again, the long through ball, and as McClure proved in the first half, one touch like that can make them so threatening. Oh, beautiful play by Kirk. Referee coming to his defence again. And Motherwell, with 15 minutes of the second half gone, have taken a command of midfield. They build up some useful moves for themselves, like this one. Bonner stretched to the feet of John Riley. Good anticipation by the Celtic goalkeeper again, who's had by far the busier of this first 15 minutes of the second half. This was a very timely save indeed. Watch Riley, any mistake and Riley would have had that plonk in the back of the net. Yes, quick one too, but stay with it. Johnson hesitated. Away go Motherwell again. Really playing well now, Motherwell. White is still in play, although that was very slow by the fullback again, Wishart. He really has to part with the ball quicker. He had players on the left of him, and now Mo Johnson. There's a brilliant ball. Aiken goes in. Can he make it? He's done it. A brilliant goal. No wonder Johnson wants to embrace him. That was all the way down the park. It's as fine a goal as a defender can possibly score. Just when Motherwell had taken the initiative, look at him calling out for the ball. Through it went. Impeccable pass, lovely timing. spoiled it if somebody had knocked that over the line. Andy Walker comes on. Just over 20 minutes of the game remaining. Well, that was a tackle that I don't think the referee, is he going to take his name for that? And stay, or just a wad in his ear? No, no booking. Free kick though. Is it Brian Wright? Well touched away now. Formic stay. There's no offside this time. Surely it's a goal. Yes, it is. Walker. Oh dear. 2-1. With exactly 20 minutes remaining, and the Celtic defence totally taken on there. They thought it was offside, which it certainly was not. And look at that lovely little swerve there, and the easiest of tasks. And we're having another substitution. John Gagan is on for Motherwell. John Gagan, a throwback to the dribbling winger, and a very fine one on his game. Minutes of a very interesting game remaining. On to Gagan. There's a touch there, and that's a good save by Bono. Steve Cook behind it. Good attack again by Motherwell. They've simply refused to lie down, and there was Cook coming in on it. I think it would have gone to the side even if the Celtic goalkeeper hadn't touched it. Now Gagan. Looks towards that far side, there's a touch, it's a goal! It's the equaliser! Would you believe it? Paul Smith, with only 2 minutes remaining. Well, did I say a portion of the praise should go to them? With that scoreline of 2-1 and Celtic looking as if they would hold on, here comes as dramatic an equaliser as you could get. Beautifully flighted and touched superbly in. They're looking a little bit tired now. We're into injury time. Right. And there goes the final whistle. Well, the first whistle at the end of 90 minutes. I suppose not to that crowd in there. We have got into extra time, which may surprise the supporters at the other end. It's not very often in a semi-final you give Celtic 2 goals at the start and a fullback, and that's exactly what's happened. And the run forward there by John Gagan, turning inside and floating that right across, and in came Paul Smith with that delicate little touch. Off we go. And the Celtic players, who are looking very stunned indeed at the end of normal time, will have to pick themselves up, and this is the very man to do it. Curls it round, it's towards Mo Johnston. Motherwell, I think, yes, conceding that. That was Brian Wright who handled that. Free kick. Useful position this for Celtic. I watched them take one or two free kicks near the penalty area. In the last three or four games, they've been very good at them, come up with some interesting variations. Now, what will we see here? Straightforward, Boomer. Nothing fancy about that, just shove it to the side and let Martin McLeod let fly. There it went, and smack. He really can hit them. Gardner doing very well to get behind that. Paul Smith. I think he'll remember his goal for a long time. Oh, a bit too deliberate. Is that high? No, the referee waves play on. No offside. Linesman was right on the spot. Andy Walker, though, on his own virtually. Through it goes, there's a great chance, and Gagan straight into the goalkeeper. The goalkeeper didn't have to move at all, and that you really put down, however excellent the ball and the diagonal run, as a clear-cut chance which ought to have been sunk. Bottom McLeod with it, up goes Gardner. And Gardner is still bothered by that shoulder. As the whistle goes, Gardner applauding his supporters at the back. That is the end of the first period of extra time. It is still 2-2. And I must say, I look forward to this last quarter of the match. And a distinct possibility that this crowd will be staying on a lot later than they thought when they arrived at Hampden Park in the light around about 7:30 tonight. Of Go Motherwell. If they do nothing else, they have won the respect of everybody here at Hampden Park tonight for the way they've taken on the favourites. Aiken just keeps at it. Now, this man. As far as Celtic is concerned, McClair should have been getting more and more of the ball. Brilliant run by McStay. There's the cutback. Robbie McLeod, and total miss kick. Brian McClair can hardly believe it. Really set up for him. Right across the bottom of the goal, and this dreadful miss kick. Watch it, put back, and Brian McClair hardly ever does that. Aiken. Don't know whether Aiken's fully recovered from that knock or not, but he's playing as if it doesn't matter at all. Goalkeeper out of his goal again, and there he is. It was right for Mo Johnson to have that try from way out. I mean, there's nothing more inviting than a goalkeeper something like 20 yards out of goal. Hammering it in hard. Farningham. There's the header, and there's Pat Bonner. There was no real strength behind Ryan Wright's header. Away goes Martin McLeod. Good run by Motherwell this, but watch the header. From a way out there, it's got to be... Well, you see, he wasn't behind the ball. He was angled to it, or else that might have been a very useful one. Down goes Celtic, the fans roaring them on. It's an inviting ball up there. It's over and offside. McClair. A distinct chance, but it was offside. The linesman did have his flag up. Now, let's watch this. There's a touch forward. I don't see how he could have been offside. We are seconds away from penalties. There it is. It's going to be a penalty finish. And the first penalty in this rather dramatic evening will be taken by the Motherwell captain, Tom Boyd, the youngest captain in the Premier Division. It is both an agonizing and exciting moment. There's so much at stake for these players in penalty finishes now. So much money in particular. The Scull Cup final beckons. Boyd to take it. 1-0 Motherwell. An inspirational start by the captain. He's leading the way for the others as Motherwell go into a penalty lead. For Celtic, Brian McClair. And this is interesting, he looked very bad in the latter stages of the game as Brian McClair makes it 1-0. Now watch the reaction of the goalkeeper, he was totally wrong-footed. But he seemed to be not too badly put out by that, fall to the ground. And now the man who scored the first goal for Motherwell, Andy Walker. Rather greasy surface there. Everybody on edge. Walker to take this. 2-1 for Motherwell. And that was done very confidently. I wouldn't swap his boots for anything, but look at that. Totally nervous. Morris Johnson, usually very good at this. 2-0, and acknowledges that loud roar of the Celtic supporters way down at the King's Park end of that ground. Again, Gardner totally wrong-footed, 2-0. This is John Philibin for Motherwell. The boy originally was Stirling, and now Doncaster back to Hampden, and this. No goal. That was clearly missed, underside of the bar by Philibin. Now watch that miss. He really hammered it. And it came back out again. And Celtic now could take the lead. Derek White. 3-2 for Celtic. And all they need to do now is keep that lead. Sweeping it in confidently. And now Brian Wright. He knows his side are trailing. He's really got to put this one away. It's in. A little sporting gesture to the Celtic supporters, you might say. That's 3-0, but of course Celtic have that advantage. A very good effort indeed by Bonner. I think the skid beat him. Paul McStay, who very rarely misses. McStay against Gardner. In it goes. And Celtic, nevertheless, at 4-3 on the verge of the Scull Cup final. Sweetly in by McStay. For Motherwell, Skibka. In it goes. We're now 4-0. And Tommy Burns could put Celtic in the Skull Cup final with his one kick. That brought the scores level. It could be the final kick of the evening. Means a lot to Celtic and to Tommy Burns. There it is. And for the second tie in succession, Celtic have gone through on penalty deciders, to the great delight of the fans and the players. And so Celtic go forward to the Skull Cup final on the 26th of October, which we are delighted to say will be seen live by viewers to BBC Scotland. The whole of the Skull Cup final on Sunday 26th of October, live on BBC Scotland, where Celtic will be represented after that final penalty kick taken by Tommy Burns. Tommy saying, in a kinder way for us, good night, see you